Hi, I hope that you'll enjoy this article on CMC arthritis outcomes entitled Psychological Characteristics, Female Sex, and Opioid Usage Predict Acute Postoperative Pain in Patients Surgically Treated for Thumb-Based Osteoarthritis, a cohort study. I find this to be a very interesting and useful article because so many patients present with ongoing base of thumb and hand pain. In fact, it's the most common arthritis that we'll see in the upper extremity. This is typically thought to be secondary to hypermobility or ongoing laxity or increased motion throughout the joint that causes grinding down of the cartilage and subsequent bone with inflammation. Early interventions then are tailored around decreasing this inflammation through corticosteroid injections, splinting, and occupational therapy to strengthen the muscles at the base of the thumb and decrease this hypermobility. However, in patients that continue to note pain and loss of function in the hand, CMC arthritis surgery can be very useful. This is typically done by removing the arthritic bone or trapezium and reconstructing the soft tissue. In this study, one of the strengths was that they looked at a large number of patients as well as a large number of surgeons, but the same or very similar operation with slight variations. Within that study, they found that narcotic pain medication, female gender, and even the fear of surgery can increase acute postoperative pain scores. These higher pain scores, of course, are not only worrisome in that pain in and of itself is to be avoided, but the agents that we use to decrease pain, such as narcotic medication, can have their own side effects, GI upset, drowsiness, nausea, vomiting, and constipation. And therefore, by identifying patients that may have risk factors for increased postoperative pain, we can use what is called a multimodal or multi-pronged approach to pain control, such as acetaminophen, ibuprofen, or even nerve blocks. Nerve blocks can be a useful adjunct that numb or dull the entire hand and upper extremity and allow for a gradual recovery following surgery. What this can mean then is that we can better identify these risk factors and ensure a more comfortable postoperative course. It should be stressed though in this study that the acute postoperative pain was lower than the preoperative pain, as well as the pain during physical load, the pain during the prior week, and the preoperative pain at rest. Therefore, this suggests that the postoperative regimen was effective in managing acute postoperative pain following CMC surgery. Overall then, as CMC surgery can be very beneficial in restoring function, dexterity, and decreasing pain, the usefulness of this article is brought through by identifying those risk factors then that can help our patients have a better, more stable, and more comfortable postoperative course and rehabilitation.